Here's our solution. You are given the unique table name. The rest of this inner class lists the columns we're going to use to store our data. Once again, you'll want to use the same constant names that I used in this solution, since the code in the other classes you've received, such as the WeatherDB helper, uses these same constant names.